welcome to Grace for Today. It's Monday. We're delighted that you're able to join us. Hope you've had a great weekend. This morning, we're going to be talking about your right to God's unmerited favour. And we're going to look at a verse from 2 Corinthians 5:21. It says, "For he, God, made him, Jesus Christ, who knew no sin, to be sin for us, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him." That's Jesus Christ. I wanted to start this morning by telling you a little bit of a story. We were away recently on our holidays. We had an amazing time down in Dingle Bay, beautiful weather, absolutely loved it. And then we booked a second week over at a place called Achill Island, which I'd never really heard of before, but it's supposed to be absolutely beautiful. And just the night before we were about to leave to go there, we received a phone call from the owner of the place we were going to stay in. And apparently there was a water shortage on the island. And they'd had so many visitors, so it was just completely unprecedented that they had actually run out of drinking water. And unfortunately, we weren't able to make the trip to go there. And it was interesting, just as I was thinking today, I thought, you know, there has been so much uncertainty over the last number of months. So many things that we thought would never actually happen have happened. And we found ourselves in unprecedented times. And, you know, we never expected to not be able to go on a holiday because they would run out of water. That's not something that we think would happen here. But do you know what? A lot of things have been shaken for a lot of us over this last number of months. But it reminded me that actually there is one that is unshakable, and that is Jesus. And no matter what's been shaken in your life over the, you know, this last season, whether it's been health issues, whether it's been your finances, whether it's been certainty about the future, relationships, so many things have felt that you know, that things just that we've relied on in the past, or we've put our hopes or our trust in, have been shaken. But I was just reminded again this weekend just that the Lord is the one who is the unshakable one, and his word and his promises to us are so sure and such a foundation for our lives. And so when you come to this verse, it's one of those things where actually we just really need to get a hold of it in our hearts and really allow that to become a reality, because it says that Jesus knew, who knew no sin, he actually became sin for us. And that this is an incredible exchange that takes place where all of our sin he took for us, and that we receive his righteousness. And you know what? I know that there's so many times I know the reality of that, or I think I know the reality of that verse. And yet there are so many times when the enemy can come in and start to shake at it and start to try and, you know, make me doubt, does that really apply to every part of my life? And I just want to challenge you today, because this whole series about looking at, you know, the 100 days of favor, we all want to walk in everything that God has planned for us, because as a loving father, he wants to lavish his love on us, and he wants his children to bring glory to this earth so that we are his representatives here, so people look at our lives and go, wow, what is it that's different about you guys, and that they see Jesus in us. But the enemy wants to get our eyes off Jesus and onto ourselves and look at all the things that disqualify us and things that we would think would make us not good enough to walk in those blessings. So I want to challenge you today. You know, most of us will agree, you know, God is good. Every good thing in our lives is because of him. And we know that verse, every good and perfect gift comes from him. But can we really truly depend on his goodness in every situation? Or are we looking at times at our failures, at things where we've messed up, times where we've got it wrong, times when we should have, you know, maybe if we'd done this, things would have been different. How many times are we conscious of ourselves, and how many times are we conscious of Jesus today? And I just wanted to ask you and just exhort you to lift your eyes up and see Jesus. You know, when he met the woman at the well, when he, you know, needed a drink, and he came to her and he said, she said, you know, that she was there at the well looking for water, and he said, you know, I am the living water. He is the true source of life for our lives. We can receive everything that we need for him. And he doesn't just give us what we need. He's a God of abundance. He's super abounding in love towards us. And he goes above and beyond. So whatever it is today that you need, whatever it is that today on a Monday morning, when your eyes are looking down the week and you're thinking, oh my goodness, you know, there's this happening, there's that happening. Do you feel a demand on your life, or are you convinced that Jesus is that supply? He's that source of life that's bubbling up towards you, that living water that's just gonna come and meet every single need that you have and go way beyond it. So let's pray today, and let's trust that the Lord is gonna give us every good thing that we need, because he became sin for us so that we can be righteous today We are totally loved, totally blessed, totally whole and accepted because of our state in Him, not because of what we've done, but because of who He is and what He has done for us. So let's pray together. Jesus, we just thank You for Your goodness. We thank You for Your love. We thank You that we are children of God. We thank You that we're Your brothers and sisters, and that You've united us into Your family. And that because of that position today, we can receive all good things from You, because You are good. Not because of ourselves, but because of Your goodness and Your love towards us. So we receive all those blessings today, all that goodness. We thank You that our blessings are not just for us, but it's for people in our lives, Lord, that we could go out today and be a blessing to those around us, Jesus, because Your life is within us. So we thank You for that. We thank You that we can have confidence about this week because of who You are and what You've done for us. Thank You, Jesus. And let's just remind ourselves as well, Jesus, that Your body was broken today, that we could walk in health and wholeness and victory, that we stand complete in You today, that we're perfect and complete. Every sickness or disease in our body, Jesus, You took, You died on the cross for us, that we could be whole today. So we receive that in Your name, Jesus. Thank You. And we thank You, Jesus, there is no condemnation today, that Your blood has completely cleansed us from all sin and all condemnation. Thank You, Lord. So I pray that you have a great day today. I pray that you're blessed. And I pray that you just stand in that righteousness that Jesus bought for you. Amen.